The Pythagorean Theorem says that for any right triangle with sides A, B, and C, we have A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Don't forget, C must be the length of the longest side of the right triangle, the hypotenuse. If a triangle is not a right triangle, then this doesn't work. A squared plus B squared does not equal C squared. Luckily, right triangles are very common, so the Pythagorean Theorem is extremely useful. So do you believe this is true, or do you know this is true? There is a difference. True mathematical knowledge comes when you understand why something is true. In mathematics, there is no hoping and believing and wishing, but there is lots of proving. A proof is a logical argument showing something is true. Let's now prove the Pythagorean Theorem. There are many, many ways to prove the Pythagorean Theorem. We'll talk about one of my favorite proofs. To begin, let's pick a random right triangle and label the sides A, B, and C. Again, be sure you label the hypotenuse C. Next, make four copies of this triangle. We are now going to arrange these four triangles to form a square. Before we do this, let's label the angles in these triangles. This will help us in a moment. Let's call the small angle alpha and the next largest angle beta. The largest angle is the right angle, which is 90 degrees. One more thing. The angles in a triangle always sum to 180 degrees, so alpha plus beta plus 90 equals 180. If you subtract 90 from both sides, you get alpha plus beta equals 90 degrees. Another way to say this is alpha and beta are complementary angles. Let's begin by arranging two of the triangles so these sides form a straight line. That means this is a 180 degree angle. And since alpha plus beta equals 90 degrees, this angle must be a right angle. Next, arrange the third triangle so we have a straight side here. Again, since alpha plus beta equals 90 degrees, this is also a right angle. And using similar logic, we can put the fourth triangle here to complete the square. The length of the sides of this square are a plus b, so the area of the big square is a plus b squared. There's another way to find the area of this square. We can add up the area of the four triangles and the small square in the middle. Remember, the area of a triangle is 1/2 base times height. So the area of each triangle is 1/2 a times b. The area of the small square is c squared. So if we add up the area of the four triangles and the small square, we get 1/2 ab plus 1/2 ab plus 1/2 ab plus 1/2 ab plus c squared. If you collect like terms, you get 2ab plus c squared. We computed the area of this square in two different ways. Both ways give the same answer, since they measure the area of the same square. So a plus b squared equals 2ab plus c squared. If you multiply out the left-hand side, you get a squared plus 2ab plus b squared equals 2ab plus c squared. We can cancel 2ab from both sides, which leaves us with a squared plus b squared equals c squared. This is the Pythagorean Theorem. We proved that it's true. There's a Latin phrase you can use to say you're finished with a math proof, quod erat demonstrandum. This means, which was to be demonstrated. If you're in a hurry, you can shorten it to QED. It's a nice way to high-five yourself for truly understanding how something works.